In colder climates, you're going to want to shut off your sprinkler system, and that probably means blowing it out with your compressor. So the first thing to do is to find the shutoff valve that's closest to the wall, next to where it comes out for the sprinkler, and shut that off. If it's a regular valve, just twist it till it's shut, and if it's a ball valve, then turn it so that it's perpendicular to the pipe. That's its off position. The next thing to do is to find your controller box, valve controller box, open that up, and what you want to do once you do that, turn on each and every one of your valves. I like these particular valves because you can do that manually with them. If you don't have manual controls, you would have to open them up, or you would have to turn them on with your controller inside. You can blow them out all at the same time, or you can, if you have fewer than three, or you can do them one at a time if you want to be extra careful. So you want to hook up the hose and turn on the valve to see if there is any water that comes out. If there are or there is none, great. If there is, wait for it to come out and then plug it in to your compressor just like that and turn it on. Make sure that you set it up for limited pressure. So you've got 60 psi. That's probably good. You're ready to turn it on. And if you see water coming out of the heads, great. If not, you can turn up the pressure a little bit at a time until you do see the water coming out of all the heads. And once all of that's out, you have only air coming out, you can shut things off. Here we've got water coming out of one of the heads. Once that's done, we shut it off. And we're almost done here. If you don't have a bleeder valve on the inside of the house so that you can clear the water from the access of the compressor all the way to the inside of the house, then you just remove that hose and insulate very, very well. If you have a full port valve like this ball valve here with a bleeder valve right there, then you can go inside the house and open that up. But first, shut off the valve that goes to the outside here, just like that, and go inside and undo that little valve, run your compressor some more, and get the water out inside the house. Make sure you put a bucket, of course, under that bleeder valve. You want to get all of that water into a bucket, not on the floor. Now you're ready to turn everything back to where it was. So disconnect the hose and turn that valve off, turn that valve on, and turn off all of the manual overrides so that you're all ready for next spring. Close the lid of the box with the manifold and all the valves. Now that everything else is done and your compressor is turned off, you can safely put that bleeder cap back on. Make sure you do that before you forget. Otherwise, next spring you're going to have a little flood if you forget and turn on your sprinklers without doing that. So don't forget.